Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of What is in the Night Sky Tonight. I'm Teagan with High Point, and tonight I'm going to take you on a beautiful tour of the night sky in the month of May. Tonight we're going to be visiting a variety of deep sky objects, then we're going to bring it a little bit closer to home and see what the moon and the planets are up to. So as always, let's buckle in and see what's really out there. Alright, so for our first deep sky object, we are going to travel outside the plane of our galaxy, nearly 33,000 light years away, to the globular cluster Messier 3. Despite being one of the brightest globular clusters in the sky, Messier 3 can be difficult to find. It's located on the border of Canes Venetici and Butes. Now that being the case, it's best to star hop and try locating the cluster with binoculars first, or a finder scope. It's visible through regular 10x50s as a conspicuous fuzzy star. Telescopically, it appears in the middle of a Y-shaped asterism formed with three other stars. At low magnification of 35 times, it appears bright, circular, and compact, while increasing the magnification to around 75 times will allow some resolution. You will notice a large bright core and a halo that uniformly fades towards the cluster's edge. Like with all globular clusters, the larger the telescope, the more grand your viewing experience. With a large enough telescope and enough magnification, you should be able to see the resolved core of Messier 3, and it may resemble diamonds on a black velvet background. Now, let's go to our next object, and it is a gorgeous galaxy several millions of light years away, Messier 104, the Sombrero Galaxy. This almost edge-on galaxy is about the same size as our Milky Way, and has a very distinctive dark dust band that helps give this galaxy its name. Small scopes show an elongated ellipse with pointed ends, while a medium-sized scope will show the dust lane cutting across the halo. Visually speaking. Now, if you're an astrophotographer and Messier 104 is one of those targets, we highly recommend imaging this with a longer focal length telescope, anything 750 or 1000 millimeters and above. This galaxy shows some gorgeous details across and just above the dust lane where you can see the plane of the galaxy. For those in the northern hemisphere, it does rise relatively low. But if you have nice seeing conditions, Messier 104 is a premium galaxy for astrophotographers. Next on our list is yet another galaxy, and arguably one of the most popular galaxies in the night sky, apart from Messier 31 Andromeda Galaxy. This galaxy is Messier 51. Messier 51 can be found within the same binocular field of view as Alcaid, the westernmost star of the Big Dipper. And while small scopes will show this galaxy, you will probably need a 300mm scope or larger to see its spiral arms. Now, Messier 51 is another favorite among amateur astrophotographers as its grand spiral design is face-on. The next object is yet another galaxy and is quite close to Messier 51 and again is extremely popular for astrophotographers. Messier 101, the Pinwheel Galaxy. Messier 101 is a beautiful face-on spiral and at a distance of 28 million light years, it is one of our nearest galactic neighbors. This is one target that benefits from a UHC filter with averted vision helping to reveal its spiral arms. Now leaving Messier 101, we bring it back to our own galaxy, we're going to take a look at a multiple star system, Cor Caroli. When it comes to double or multiple stars, many beginners cut their teeth on Ursa Major, Mizar, and Alcor. However, there are thousands more to choose from, and one of the easiest and best is Cor Caroli, the brightest star in Canes Venetici, the hunting dogs. You can find it 14 degrees south of Alcaid, the star at the end of the Big Dipper's handle. and it can be split with almost any telescope at low power. A magnification of 26 times is all you need to see both components. The primary star is white and perhaps 2 or 3 times brighter than the secondary, which can appear pale gold or cream color. Now, while most of the other targets on this list were favored among amateur astrophotographers, Cor Caroli is definitely one of those targets that are visually very pleasing. So far in this tour, we have visited 5 deep sky objects, and now we're going to bring it back much closer into our own solar system, and we're going to see what the moon and the planets are up to. Uranus is in conjunction with the Sun on the 9th, with Neptune also invisible. However, both Venus and Mars can still be seen in the evening sky, with the waxing crescent moon to the lower right of Venus on the 22nd, and then to its upper left on the 23rd. The moon then hangs just above Mars the following night. Rise early and you may see Saturn low in the southeast at about an hour before dawn, with the last quarter moon to its lower right on the 13th. If you have a clear view towards the east, you may also be able to spot Jupiter low over the horizon from around mid-month onwards. A thin waning crescent moon appears slightly more than a degree to its right on the 17th. If you're looking for a challenge, try Mercury during the last week of the month. Start looking around 20 minutes before sunrise. In regards to the moon, it turns full on the 5th and then new on the 19th. Alright, so that is our tour for the night sky in the month of May. If you have any questions, please let us know in the comments. If you've seen these objects, or maybe you've photographed some of these objects, let us know your entire experience. We love to hear from you guys. Again, please like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel for all things amateur astronomy and astrophotography. Thank you so much, and clear skies.